Hallelujah. I've just been spending time with, worshiping the Lord. And I felt him say to me, I felt he was wanting to say something. And he showed me a cross, like a crucifix, like I was looking kind of up at it, and I said, the cross, I said, why show me that? And he said, because it was meant for so many, but so few have received it. And I said, why are you telling me what do you want? Why? What do you want me to do? What I felt he was saying is that this virus, this whole thing, has put an end to the puffed up self-importance of the church. and the idea that the church has, that it is the church, I know it uses this token kind of, you know, this kind of token, it's not us, it's the church, it's the bodies that's the church. But they think they're the church, they think they're kind of indispensable or something. But they're not here anymore. Where are they? There isn't a church, there's no congregating, there's no church, the buildings are empty. And God has not been pleased with the way they've gone. There's no doubt about it. I know that might make a lot of you very, very angry. But that's too bad. Because, let's face it, if you were so important to God, where are you? You are scrabbling for your iPads and your tech and all your other stuff to stay relevant. Because you're not relevant. You're not. There's no power in your midst. That you've not preached the whole counsel of God. You've not been bearing fruit. You've merely been attracting devotees to your club. You've not been creating disciples who lay down their lives for Jesus Christ. And I'm sorry, but the joy of the Lord, wow. You've not been creating disciples who realize they died, they die at the cross and they live for him, and they're here while they're on this earth to do the works of God, to do exploits and to live as the new creation. You've lied to the people. You've lied. You've told them, this is the way. This repetitious nonsense is the way. But it's not the way. It's not the way. Living for God is 100%. It's not clubs and activities. It's not interesting authors. It's not the opinions of men. It's in the Word of God and the Holy Spirit. That's what it is. Those that live and walk by the Spirit shall be called the sons and the daughters. The sons and the daughters of God. They're it. You know, the church isn't here, but God's still here.